All right, so we've been talking about photosynthesis for now for how long? Week? 2 weeks.
Okay.
We should be getting pretty good with the process. Okay, you guys have, you've actually practiced drawing this. Who can tell me what this is?
A chloroplast.
Good, picture of a chloroplast. Okay, we talked about the light reactions. Yesterday we studied the Calvin cycle. Okay, does anyone remember what the Calvin cycle does? Good. So its purpose is to provide sugar. Okay? Provide sugar for that plant, right? The energy comes from where? If you're looking at this chloroplast, where would it come from? It comes from our light reactions. Our light reactions come from where?
The light.
The sun, which is our ultimate source of light energy. Our ultimate source of energy. Okay, good. So this process is recurring, right? In the plants, they have to have this in order to live. If plants can't provide photosynthesis, then what happens? Plants die. Plants die, what happens? Ultimately, they start the food chain, right? So, just like we talked about, if plants aren't there, what are some animals that eat plants?
Humans.
Any herbivores. We'll learn about that when we study ecology. But anything that eats plants. Rabbits eat plants. Cows, whatever. Okay, so that if that directly affects us, that's why it's important that we see how it works in our real life. Question.
So if a cow doesn't eat grass,
does it still
produce?
But what do they? What do you mean? What are they producing? So cows are going to need a certain amount of nutrients to be able to provide that meal.
If they don't eat,
and get enough nutrients, then they'll be. Then they won't be able to produce them if they have to. So they can get nutrients in other ways, depending on what that farmer wants to do. They can get it through feed and seed, that kind of thing. But they're going to want to eat grass. Cows eat nonstop, right? Okay, so back to this. I want to show you a real world example. This is a lab. It takes a little bit of time, so that's why we're going to kind of, because we're on our shorter block today, I'm going to demonstrate this, but we'll talk through exactly what's happening, okay? So in this jar is sodium bicarbonate solution. Okay, what do you think's in a sodium bicarbonate solution?
Salt.
What's it sound like in the name?
Sodium.
Sodium. Okay. How about the carbonate? Bicarbonate. Carbon, right? So carbon dioxide. And how does carbon dioxide play a role in photosynthesis? Good. It takes it in for. Yeah, it takes in for the Calvin cycle, right? The Calvin cycle takes that energy, essentially churns up that carbon dioxide in order to be able to make that sugar, right? So this is the solution that I'm going to pour in this cup. Now I'm going to have my proper safety procedures, okay? I don't want to hit myself in the eye with my syringe here. But so I'm going to pour this bicarbonate solution in this cup, all right? This is essentially what's going to generate my CO2, which we know is important for the Calvin cycle. Alright, now I'm going to take my plant. Basically all this is spinach leaves.
Yeah.
You've eaten spinach, right?
I do.
You guys don't like it. You don't like vegetables, right?
I eat spinach, like, yeah, I can't eat it. Like,
I eat
most. Alright, so I'm going to take my highly technical hole punching device here. This is just a piece of straw. And I'm going to punch holes in it. I'm going to punch about 5 just for the sake of this study. So when I put these leaves into this bicarbonate solution, do you think they're going to float or do you think they're going to sink? Float?
Sink.
Some of you say float, some of you say sink. Why would you think they would float?
I say they'll sink.
You think they'll sink?
Yeah.
Why do you think they'll sink?
Because you put holes in
them. I put holes in the leaves? I'm not going to put the whole leaf. I'm just going to put the leaf, the little pieces of the leaf that are now sitting inside of the straw. So let's see. If you anybody ever been to the pool? You seen a leaf in a pool? What's it doing?
Floating.
It's floating, right? Sometimes they're sinking at the bottom. Okay, so I'm gonna use my pipe cleaner here, and I'm gonna put these leaves inside of this, and I'll show you why here in a second. So I've got 5 pieces of that leaf. So now answer the question. Do you think they're going to float, or do you think they're going to sink? They're going to float, right? What's in these? We've studied this. So what's in these leaves that are going to help them float? What keeps them sinking?
Carbon
dioxide? Oxygen? Okay, what are those? Liquid or a gas? They're gas. They're a little bit less dense. Right now, these leaves are a little less dense because there's air in it. Okay? Because that's what CO2, that's what oxygen are. Those are gases that help things float. So what I'm going to try to do is, I don't know if you think I can or not, I'm going to try to get these to sink. Okay? So this is going to show us what's happening in photosynthesis. So I'm going to take the air out of this. All right, and I'm going to essentially kind of pull on it. This is a high pressure vacuum here, and when I pull on it, it's going to hopefully, within a trial or two, take that air out. Okay? When that air comes out, is it going to float or is it going to sink? In an ideal world, it sinks. Let's see if it works. Now, what are they doing? Okay, they're sinking. So I've successfully taken that air out. Now, I'm going to pour this back into this cup. This cup's just filled with the same bicarbonate solution. And now they're sinking. Alright? So, in order to get these to float again, so let's go back to the example of our leaves in the pool. Okay? You see those leaves in the pool, a lot of times they're kind of dead, right? They're dead leaves, maybe it's fall, autumn, whatever. They're not alive anymore to be able to conduct that photosynthesis. What would it take to get these leaves to rise, you think? Sunlight. Good. Why is sunlight so important? You're on it.
Invisible light reactions.
Good. So that light is going to essentially hit the pigments. What are the pigments in this leaf called? Chlorophyll, that's where that sunlight's going to come, okay? It's going to hit there, that light reaction is going to happen. Even though this disc is really super small, each one of these spinach leaf discs are so small, that's where they're going to happen, okay? And once that ATP starts to be produced, what role does ATP have in photosynthesis? ATP, NADPH, can you figure it out based on this picture up here? We mentioned it yesterday. ATP.
Oh, it's the little light.
What's that POW sign?
It's going to the light reaction.
Good. So that you're exactly right. It's what helps get to that process, right? So that ATP is our. There's one word I'm looking for. Energy. Okay, that's our energy to be able to happen. So once that light happens, this energy starts. There's carbon dioxide.
It's going to give the energy to come back up.
Exactly. That energy is using the process of photosynthesis, okay? And where is my carbon dioxide coming from in this cup? We talked about it.
There's a solution.
Yeah, there's carbon in here. This is a bicarbonate solution. So that CO2 is being pulled in. If I put this under a light lamp, that light's going to help you get that energy. And eventually, maybe 15, 20 minutes, we would see, maybe even less, we would see these actually start to rise. Okay? Because what it would be producing? It's producing, one, it's using the energy to produce glucose, which is ultimately what those plants want for energy storage later on. But also, what?
Oxygen.
And when oxygen goes in and those gases start filling back up this plant leaf, what are they going to do? They're going to float back to the top. That's the idea anyway. Okay? If they don't float back to the top, it could be a couple things. Maybe this leaf's too old, maybe it's kind of dead and not any longer to, it cannot perform photosynthesis anymore just because it doesn't have, it's not healthy enough. A lot of conditions. What other conditions could affect whether this is actually going to happen or not? Maybe not enough light. Okay, good. What else? What do you think, Demetrius? Do you think temperature has anything to do with it?
Yeah.
What kind of temperature would I need for photosynthesis to be able to happen?
Warm.
Okay, so when do you see the most photosynthesis actually happen?
Spring,
summer, right? Around the equator, it's pretty much happening all the time, right? So we see those leaves fall off in the fall time because they've already stored up enough glucose. They don't need to be able to make it anymore. Okay? So does this make sense and give you a little bit better example of how it actually works in real life?